Hello, Professor. My name is Lam Din. This is my extra credit question. So, it's a module 3, slide 5. And I have to change these two number by my last PID number, and I add 2, so I have 10. Also, the given is T1 is register I, a counter I, register S2 is the result. It's register S0 is the mem array, and had to transfer this code to C language. So to start, I'm gonna explain for each line how can I transform it into C language. So first of all, this one, what I have is initially I equal to 10. I is actually just a counter, it's not the index of the mem array. I will call J is the index of the array. For this line, we have to load the value of the base address of the mem array into the register S1, which means that mem array J, okay, when J equal to 0, we load that value into register S1. Right here, we add the result value to the mem array of J and store it to the result. For this line, as you see, is we add 4 to the base address of the mem array. The reason we add 4 is we move to the next value. We add 4 to the address because 4 byte is 1 word. So when we move, this is for 8 byte. And keep going so that if we want to move to the next value, you have to add 4 byte. Which mean? Alright, for this line, we increment I to 10. And this 2 is a condition. They state that if I is less than 100, we go back to the loop. And we keep going like that. So if I is greater than 100, out of the loop. Alright, so I compare all this thing into the C code, so I'm gonna run it for you too. So let's call the mem array with 10 value from 1 to 10. Okay, I initial I equal to 10, I have to initial result and also J, because in the MIPS all the value, all the register, the value initially equal to 0. And because the condition is in the bottom, so I will choose the do while loop for this loop. Okay, so first of all, I add the result value with the mem array J and store it to the result. After that, I increment 10. I also increment J, and I will print the result and return with 0. Because I is just a counter, and when I initially 10 and it's keep adding 10, and it has to be less than 100, so the mem array is going to be the first 9 number, the first 9 number of the array gonna be added together to have the result. So that is my test plan. In order to test that, let's run this test. So when I use my calculator, I add 1, add 2, until add 9, I have 45, which is satisfy my test plan. Also, I can make it more simpler by using for loop. In calculation, I can make j equal to I divided by 10 minus 1, because if I is 10, 10 divided by 10 minus 1, j equal to 0. That makes sense because we start at the index 0. Okay, another example is 20. 20 divided by 10 is 2 minus 1, so j equal to 1. We go to the next index. Then we can use a for loop to make it very fast. So for instead of do while, we just need two lines for the for loops. And also for the confirmation, I will check this loop, I mean check this code to Mars program. So the result I have is 45. So this word file is the explanation and a solution for my extra credit. And I will post this video to the YouTube, so you can load it. Thank you for listening to my vlog. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. Have a good day.